In this video, we're discussing a career path that can be highly lucrative and also very rewarding. But it's often overlooked by many high school, college graduates, and people just looking to make a change in their career for that matter. And that job, or that career, is professional selling. Now, I define professional sales as the act of providing value in exchange for money. There are three classifications of sales roles. The first being the passive. The passive person is basically receiving sales, receiving customers without really having to do anything. The second is the hunter, and their efforts are focused on solely going out, finding new business, finding customers. The third is the farmer. They're usually assigned a customer base, and their role is to grow the sales and revenue. Types of sales roles include transactional salespeople, which are basically like retail. So think going to Walmart, going to Target. Although they are doing some form of selling, the complexity of it is usually not very intense, and they're not necessarily having to go out and seek their own customers or develop large relationships with the customers that they currently have. We're going to consider transactional or retail as a passive type of sales classification. Retail salespeople are usually compensated on an hourly wage and rarely have a bonus or a commission structure attached to it. And that also usually rules out benefits as well. The second sales type is the lead generator. This is the person who usually is involved in more complex sales cycles, such as real estate or larger contracts. And they have a sole purpose of going out and finding new customers, typically door to door or over the phone for the most part. And they are considered hunters. Their compensation is usually going to be better than that of a retail salesperson, but not to the degree of people who are actually going out and closing the sales. They may have a compensation package that includes a bonus or some type of commission if the sale closes, and they also may include benefits, but they're typically not going to be the highest compensated. Account managers are a typical farmer type role where they're offered a customer base and the expectation is that they grow the revenue in that territory or the customer base by offering different lines of product or finding ways to upgrade their customers. Now, if they do a good job, they're usually paid on a bonus structure or a commission structure, but it's usually on top of a salary or an hourly wage. Now, if they do a really good job, they'll often gain referrals. The fourth type of salesperson is the inside salesperson. Now, this person is out cold calling typically all day long, and they are true hunters. Sometimes they're offered lead generators. However, their paycheck is directly determined on the amount that they sell, which can be a good thing because that could allow them to get significant commissions and significant pay as a result. The fifth type of salesperson is the outside salesperson. And now these people are typically responsible for going out and closing business, gaining new customers, meeting with customers. And a lot of times the investment that the company makes in these people is usually a bit higher because they may have to pay for car expenses. They may have to pay for phone expenses and a number of things that they wouldn't necessarily have to pay for account managers, inside salespeople, and everything else. Now, they could also have a significantly high compensation just because the companies are investing in them and their jobs are usually going out and discussing more complex topics, more complex sales cycles. If income is your main focus, I would recommend that you look heavily into the inside and the outside sales types because they typically have the highest pay. Now, you also want to find a company that's willing to invest in you in terms of training and just different sales strategies and things like that. It's also important to note business to consumer sales versus business to business sales. Business to consumer sales is usually a more simple transaction, although it can be fairly complex at times. And that's when a business sells directly to the end user, whereas business to business sales is almost always significantly more complex, requires contracts, volume commitments, and different things of that nature, and the dollar amount is usually significantly higher. I think one of the most important things you can do is starting to build a sphere of influence where you become regarded as an expert in a specific field. People will begin to refer to you because of the track record that you have and the knowledge that you bring to the table, which is typically significantly more than what your job description requires. There's also sales positions that are non-customer facing, and those are things like business development, which goes out and they create partnerships for the customer facing team or the company as a whole. Sales management, which basically manages the customer facing team or various levels of management. Sales support, which could make proposals or be part of customer service or do different tasks that aren't necessarily revenue generating, but contribute to the people who are revenue generating. And then there's online marketing or marketing teams, which basically work behind the scenes through virtual or print media. If I had to make three recommendations to landing a great job, it would be these three. Start learning how to cold call and to build your sales skills. Now that could be things from basically introducing yourself to other people and learning how to speak with them and communicate, learning the sales process, etc. Step two would be finding out how to do research, and that's figuring out what companies can get you to the place you want to go, will offer adequate wages, and also be able to teach you what you want to learn. Step three is basically going out and developing a work ethic that allows you to push past the pain of some of the rejection and the challenges that you're going to have to deal with along the way. Now, once you can do those three things, to go potentially on LinkedIn and find specific individuals within the area that you're looking to work in and start developing relationships with them. Because if you can do four specific things well, which is basically build a network, who you know, build your knowledge, what you know, develop a work ethic, step three, and four, have a good attitude to the job that you have, then I think you can pretty much get almost any job that you want and be successful at it in the long term. If you made it this far in the video, I really do appreciate you watching to the very end. Please like, share this video if you found it any bit helpful, and subscribe for any future videos, because in the future, I'll be going through what the sales process looks like, how to better communicate with other people, and overall, this should help improve your skills and eventually lead to making more money in the long run. Thank you again, and take care.